Sit to my stomach by the vending machines. They talk to me. I miss it back home where I could be free.
My dating sims dream 2 can't come soon enough. So true! That yellow, yeah? Monster seeking monster, make a laugh. I don't know if we could get that many people on a spontaneous note, but I think I'll consider it as a would be funny, like, you know, maybe a future dating game stream, because I need to plan ahead. Planning ahead was required for that one, because I want to get like a nice group of people together for that one then.
Talk to me, I miss you back home, well, I could really be free, I'm free to be something. Turn the lights up, crawl, set my mind up, I know it's getting hard for you, my dear, oh, so, pack your life up, run away with someone I don't know that I trust, it's easier to burn love than fear.
Idea. Yeah, indeed.
But the hard part is deciding, drowning, smiling. And I feel sick to my stomach by the vending machines. They talk to me, I miss you back home. Well, I could really be free. I'm free to be something.
Cat vibe, for real. Based. Hi P, hi James, and welcome in, lads. I hope you are excited. I don't remember if Emily Is Away has a soundtrack, not gonna lie. Bro does not remember. It's so goofy. Rip nab. Let's see. But yeah, welcome to the second dating game stream. I know. There was just simply too many to put in one singular stream, so we're doing it again. We're back on track. Oh my god, that's horrendous. Spoilerinos. Not spoilerinos, but try to find a playlist. Because it's a bit quiet. No, there's not enough. Screen share. People are shy. Okay, we can try, but if it lags the stream or any issues occur, then we are gone. Daughters. There you go, King. Get that in. But yeah, we're starting off with a classic. I thought we'd start with some nice familiar territory. I feel like a lot of people have seen. Would it be okay if I do funny voices for the guys? Yes. You could do silly voices. Naps and VC just being a silly goober. Which is great. I love little silly goobers around. And I'm very hyped because I have seen some people play this game. But it's been a while. And also it is a like choices matter type game where you can choose different dialogue options. So each playthrough is a little bit different. So if you don't know Emily's Away, it is an absolute classic of free sort of old school aesthetic games. This is an interactive story where we have a branch of narrative. It's about a mysterious girl called Emily. And it's all through like AOL type instant messenger aesthetics, which I was too young for because I am epic. Yeah, no, by the time that I was old enough to do like social stuff on the internet, that was like when modern social media was already around, like Instagram and Twitter and whatever. So I was not an AOL messenger child, which is a good thing, mind you, considering my age. Like if I was, I would have been like a like, 7-year-old on social media, which would not be a good thing, so let's all be thankful that all I did on the internet was play, like, Flash games on websites as an 8-year-old, so goated. Right, but yeah, I don't really remember how this game goes. I do know there's sequels. So, let's just jump in. This is the only straight game on the list today, lads. The other games I chose are all gay, so, we're just gonna cosplay as if we're straight today. Straight game, Monkey Giga? Yes. Straight games SMHing, yeah. So, our stream name is gonna be Yellow... What would be a name that would happen in those days? Wait. I'm cooking. Let him cook. Get on straight 1993. I'm gonna do. Wait. You can't even tell. It's yellow, but with two ones for instead of L's. Look, you can kind of see it here. Change to E to a 3. Oh, classic. Yes! Why does that look cool? Alright, there we go. Let's go in. Oh my god, epic. Ooh, this is not aged well. I will go with the Red Hot Chili Peppers. No, it doesn't. Okay, does it not look good? Does it look sus? Looks mid at best, oh my god. Oh, I'm sorry, I just think it looks kind of charming. Maybe it is because it's that old school names. It's good for the context. Yeah, because I actually do know I'd like some of the songs that the Red Hot Chili Peppers have made. My mom introduced them to me when I was a wee beb. Oh my god. It had my like actual friends there, that's creepy. Emery has signed in, I'm gonna say howdy. Emily! Howdy! I would never say howdy to people, like, unironically, except if it's meowdy, then it's okay. I'll turn the sound a bit down, because it's quite loud. Meowdy, yes. Oh, well, that's the wrong one. I meant meowdy. There we go. We got him. Well, howdy, partner. I like your new buddy icon. The Red Hot Chili Peppers are great. So what's up? Nothing much. What about you? Okay, what are you up to? Okay, fair enough. Ooh, wait, I can make the font a different color. Wait, let me see. Nothing, just listening to some music. Do you like Coldplay? Oh, the text is unreadable. We'll keep it black. What does this do? Oh, the box. Alright, I'm not that fast. Meowdy. This is Emery. We live in a beautiful world. Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. Coldplay. Why fear death? Just because you know the song will end. Is there any reason not to listen? XXX. Okay, Emily. With that spelling. Alright, mate. I'm kind of ambivalent. I like one or two songs from Coldplay, but not, like, I'm not really into them as a band. So I'm just going to be like, I don't know. I don't really know. I've never really listened to them. That's kind of true. They're shit, Megalol. There's like one song called Yellow that I like, but otherwise I'm just kind of like, what? Emily will remember that, PeepOS. You should definitely listen to them. I really like them. The lyrics are in my info. The lyrics are bad. That are in, like, these are some boring ass lyrics. Emily, have some better taste. No, I'm kidding. Everyone's music taste is chill and fine. I don't really like when people are pretentious about music tastes. Are you going to Travis's party tonight? I'm gonna say it depends on if you're going. Just gonna slide into her DMs real quick. I deleted that winky face! That's so real, Yellow. That's so real. Instant messenger, Yellow. I'm like... That is based as fuck. Lol, well I am, so you should totally go. It's crazy that we're already having end of school parties. I'm gonna say... Travis is shithead, no. Time flew by this year. That's so real as well. College is so close. Yeah, so this is like the classic setting for a US-centric YA story. It's always the summer, like, before college. I know it. I'm excited. I'm so over school. Blah. Emily knows what's up, man. Emily's blank in the messages. So silly. Like, you know, Brad from my math class, he won't stop messaging me right now. Oh my god. Brad. What's he saying? I'm not gonna be immediately, like, letting her know if I don't like Brad. But, I mean, the guy's name is Brad. I'll just be real. Then he wants to talk or something. I'm not really paying attention, blah. Oh man, just one more month until graduation. We're so old. Guy, you are not old. You know, I want to see if I can't get, like, a slightly... I'm trying to get some themed music. Pause. Yes. There we go. Nice. I found a playlist called Soft Romantic Instrumentals. I feel like that's the vibe. I can't hear a people clap. Sorry, King. I'm gonna say, I'm so excited for college. Yeah, I'm so excited for college. Did you pick a school yet? Imagine not having picked a school at this point. You're kinda... Either you're taking a gap year or you're in trouble. I think I accepted to my reach school. I'm just going to one of the others. Is that a phrase? I thought it was like dream school. Is... Huh? Does she mean like easy to reach? I'm confused, but anyway. But that's okay. Anything better than high school? Where are you gonna go? I'm gonna go out of these ones in art school. I'm not really sure what I want to major in, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. Yeah. Although everyone I've ever heard talking about going to art school has, like, talked about how they regret going to art school, so, like... Cry. Yeah. Art school, I'm not really sure what I want to major in. Yeah. That's great. You've always been really talented. I'm sure whatever major you pick, you'll be great. A reach school is a college university the student has relatively low probability of gaining admission to. Oh, as in it is a reach to get there, peepo G. Even though you go to different schools, you promise me you'll be there for me. Absolutely. Nothing could ever keep me from talking to you. You're my best. Oh, he undid it there. To go, you're one of my best friends instead of my best friend. Classic backpedaling. You don't want to come on too strong, like, you just want to chill. Like, what if she doesn't think the same? I so have done this. Like, I don't think I've ever been first to call someone my best friend. I always wait until they call me their best friend, and then I'm like, okay, now I know that I'm not horrifically misreading this entire situation, and now I can call you my best friend if I want to, of course. But, like, oh my god, I don't even remember that. Who's on our buddy list, by the way? Brad, Emily, that's Blue Moderator, Travis, Jules, Brooke, Herstory, Isaac, Jobbot, and May, Night in the Woods. Why is May Night in the Woods here? I'm... Sorry, just Blue Moderator being there. Yeah, Blue. And also May is here. I just didn't see her because she's all the way at the top. I can't. No, I don't want to quit this chapter. I want to go back to Emily's chat. And you're one of mine too. You always will be. Aww. Oh wow, it's getting late. I hope Julie gets here soon so we can head to the party. Does this use your Discord, Danky? Maybe. It could be my Steam wishlist. My Steam friends, I assume. Because I'm both friends with Bog and Blue Moderator on Steam. I'm going to say... I hope so too. Seems kind of wrong to ask her who Julie is, considering we're meant to be one of her best friends. Haha, thanks. You're supposed to come over when we're both heading to Travis' party. If you're coming soon too, you should probably leave soon, but I'll see you there. I'm gonna say definitely. Yeah, definitely. Chose to attend the party. I'd be like, me in real life decided to go to a party just because you're like graduating, like, you're like you should. Awesome, I'm going to go get ready and wait for Julie. Hopefully Brad stops messaging me once I put my away message. Blah. See you soon. I'll say later. Bye. The drama. There's already chapter one. Chapter two, oh my god. We're in uni. Or college. My god. Do we? We can't get. We can't keep our. Or can we? Or do we want to be a cat or dog, lads? The voice is, I want to open mic, but not really, because I'm scared. No worries, King. You could just use a soundboard if you want to, like, do silly interjections. I'll be a cat. I know, but, like, the voices. That's so true. Where's my buddy list? Now it's deleted all of my actual friends. I want to do voices, the voices. That is so true. Emily, Elias had it. Yellow, hey! How's it shaking though? What's up? Hey, what's up? I'm just doing some homework, listening to music, you, I'm just gonna say, just chilling. What's up? What music are you listening to? Snow Patrol. Okay, they just came out with their new album, Final Straw. Have you heard of it? I think I've heard one Snow Patrol song. It's like, okay. I'm gonna say, no, I don't think so. Because I also don't really know if I have or not. I don't remember what album the song was from. You should listen to it, it's really good. How are you liking art school? I'm gonna say it's hard. It's like the first year, you're gonna struggle. I always have a lot of work, but at least I'm learning a lot. Good response. Well, that's good at least. My classes all have been boring freshman stuff. Got any plans tonight? I'm gonna say hang out with friends. I wouldn't go to a house party, I don't think. Well, I have. I was about to say. I have gone to house parties, but... I don't know. Yeah, I have to go in a few. I'm hanging out with some people at my friend Mike Storm. Why are you capitalizing the word friend? Also, why are you capitalizing the word few? Maybe that's just what F's look like. Oh cool, what are y'all trying to do? Go to see a movie, go to a concert, having a few drinks. I'm gonna say go to see a movie. Cause we're like your friend. Yeah, I'm secretly hooking up with Mike. Ain't no way. Cause you're like 19, and it's like this is a US game, because they're talking about college, so you would be it would be illegal to drink. What are you going to do? We're just going to see a Mivy movie. Final Destination 2 came out a few weeks ago. Do you have plans tonight? Hey, what are you doing? Just inviting someone in? Nerd, Pepe Point. Well, I mean, the drinking age is like 18 for everything in Germany, and then beer and stuff is 16. So by the time I went to uni, I was very much of drinking age. So, nope, Brad is band practice, so I'm just hanging out in my dorm. Sounds like a tool. I'm gonna say Brad who? Admittedly, there's a lot of Brads. I know it's probably the Brad from school. No, I'm saying you're not because of Final Destination 2. Fair enough. Brad, he's my boyfriend. Brother, you remember him from high school, right? We've been dating for a couple months now. Shocker. Yeah, whatever. No, I'm going to say I'm happy for you. Because you always got to say you're happy. How did you two get together anyway? Really? Sunnyflower, thank you so much for the follow, King. Welcome in. I love how it's like, how to get together anyway, then I deleted the anyway. Because I was like, that sounded too mean. Thanks, Nap. I'm happy for you. How did you get together? Well, remember that grad party we went to last year? While I was away, Brad sent me a ton of messages about how he felt. First, I thought it was really weird, but after a while, I realized it was kind of brave. Blep. Blep. All of you stream awards watchers. Showing off your little badge. Very cute. Started talking again over the summer and realized we were going to the same school. Once we got here, and we just kind of hit it off. What's he like? We're not gonna, like, the other ones sound too jealous. Like, we gotta play it cool, guys. So, what's he like? Because we don't know Brad very well, apparently. Well, he's smart and funny and he understands me. Okay, Emily. But does he fuck you good? No, I'm sorry. Valid question, okay? Sorry, it's a valid question. It's a valid question. I did put the, like, explicit language warning for the stream. I'm sorry! I mean, it's true, though. Because she immediately goes, sometimes he can be a jerk, but when it's good, it's really good. Like, you know what is he saying? Does he have a large wiener? Well, I mean, I wasn't quite jumping to deck size yet, but like, I'm just saying, like, I did put the, like, was it sexual content warning for the stream because I want to be a bit silly with it. I'm gonna say, a jerk? Wait, how is he a jerk to you? We're not really playing this cool, guys. We're not playing this cool. We're so obvious. I just mean we get into arguments sometimes. Do you really, though? We're both very stubborn people, so we can go back and forth a lot. Okay, I think the F is just weirdly capitalized. But like I said, when things are good, they're really good. I'm gonna say, I guess that's normal. Shuck. I mean, I guess that's normal, as long as you're okay. Yeah. I mean, it's a bit weird that immediately in the introduction to someone who doesn't know Brad, you're all talking about how he's a jerk to you, but you know, whatever. I am, we just get loud when we argue as well, is that... Never mind. Oh, shut up. I'm gonna say, I just really care about you. Okay, just know, I really care about you. I really... Ooh, I was like, that sounds wrong.
Meow.
Meow. I know there are people who really care about you. I'm really backtracked. In-game yellow, man. You gotta stick to your guns. This man just backtracks every 3 seconds. Just let her know that you like her. Like, even in a friend way. Not even in a romantic way in particular. Listen, I think we're fine. I don't want to talk about this anymore. You should break up with him. No, I'm gonna say I'm sorry. Because, yeah, I was a bit pushy. I just want you to be happy. So true. I have played this game and did not enjoy it, SMHing. But I am happy, I promise. Oh, wow, it's getting late. Why did you not enjoy it? I think this is kind of like a silly game if you don't take it super seriously. I do like the aesthetics a lot. To go see your friends, don't you? I'm gonna say... I can stay. I mean, I can stay. I'm happy, I promise. Sure. Mmm, sausage. Haha, that's very nice of you, but I don't want you to miss anything. I'll talk to you later. Later. People's sauce. Pepper sauce. Sausage! Drop some sausages in the chat. I'm not trusting the boyfriend. I take everything too seriously, Siren. I mean, that's fair enough, people pat. I mean, I'm just playing this because like I wouldn't be interested in Emily anyway, for obvious and also Mean Girls! Yes, because I just watched the Mean Girls movie. And I'm gay coding myself in this game against the game's will. Hi, hello, sausage. This song is so intense. Why is this on soft romantic instrumentals? This is not soft, man. There you go. Hello, I'm gonna say, Emily, hey, we're gonna be exciting. In our typing style. And yes, I'm overthinking my typing style. How's life? I feel like we haven't talked in a while. I'm gonna say, it's good. How's your... How's yours? It's fine. Got any plans this weekend? Warehouse party! Yup, I'm very much the guy to go to a warehouse party, clearly. Going to a show, I'll say. To a show with my friend, Emma. Shocker. That sounds like fun. Who's Emma? Just a girl, like from the guy who did like musicals, yeah. I was just going through my musicals playlist. I have like every musical I've watched, and I just have all my favorite songs in there, and then I just like have a banger time. I'm gonna say a friend. Oh, she's one of my friends, Cat Rock based. Oh, cool. I don't think I've heard you talk about her before. How did you two meet? Well, I guess Mike could have introduced us. At one of his parties last year. Cool. Imagine talking to a guy who says he's straight and his instant message profile picture is Mean Girls. Like, girl. Siren. I mean, not to like, straight people can enjoy Mean Girls, but like how likely? yeah, sure, sorry. So much, like, kind, funny, hot. I'm gonna say kind. Oh, she's just a sweetheart. Emily will remember that. Oh, wow, yeah, it sounds like things are going really well. That's just so great. Why are you so passive? Okay, hear me out, right? I've done literally nothing to Emily, ever. And she's just like, that's so passive-aggressive. Wow, that's just so great. Period. She put a period there. I mean, to be fair, this might be a more modern-day texting thing, but I feel like whenever someone adds a period at the end of a sentence, it just makes it sound like they're upset or like it's super serious. I'm gonna say, so how's everything? I'll just be like kind of open. Everything kind of sucks. Recording some sounds from the soundboard, chatting. Me and Brad broke up last week. Well, good riddance, damn. I'm gonna say, I'm so sorry. Probably, I'm so sorry, how are you? I mean, she could also just be like, I'm glad, but I'm okay, it's just a really weird since. I mean, they've been together for like 2 years, right? Me and him have had the same group of friends, so things are messy. I just feel really alone, you know? Oh. I'm gonna say, I understand. Totally understand how you're feeling. Yeah, it's rough. It's just so awful, I feel abandoned, it's like I have no friends here anymore. so how are classes? I'm gonna say they're real shitty friends. They sound like shitty friends. Yeah, because like abandoning someone just because they break up is kind of sucky. I guess so, but they were my only friends. Oh, people pat. They would rather be friends with Brad. Like, what did I do wrong? Oh man, I'm starting to cry. I'll say, not please don't cry. Just gonna say, I'm so sorry. But it's their loss, misspelling there. You're an amazing person. Also me calling her M, very intimate. Okay. Thanks, I'm sorry for being such a mess. I'm gonna say you're not a mess. Being upset about breaking up is very normal. You're just sad, that's totally okay. Yes, support her feelings. Come on, be a decent fella. Thank you, it's nice to be able to talk about this. I haven't really had the chance to vent yet. Did they say vent in like 2007? Or 2004 is this? Because it, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but like, to me the word vent feels like really new. At least in this context. I'm gonna say, no problem. At all. Deleting, typing. I want to ask you something, but I'm afraid you'll hate me after. Promise me you won't hate me.
Zoinks.
I'm gonna say, I promise. Zoinks. What is it? At Travis's party senior year. Remember how we got bored and went for that walk? We stopped at that playground for a bit. Some big exposition. And we just laid there and looked at the stars. Scared. Well, why did you kiss me? Girl, what do you mean? Hey, no, like, I don't know, because I'm a guy and I don't, you know, I don't want to like hurt your boundaries. I'm just gonna be honest. I mean, like, I like meatballs. And I'm gay. Yeah, we're gonna say I didn't want to screw things up, which is quite true. Also, she's like, why didn't you read my non-verbal signals? And I'm like, bro. Be so for real. I just always wondered how things would be if you did. I don't know, it's kind of stupid, I guess. I'm gonna say I wanted that too. That's kind of neutral-ish. Girl's gonna be like, I texted you that I wanted you to kiss me. Awkward. Hey, I have an idea. Maybe you could visit this weekend. Could really use some time away from the school. We always said we would visit each other. What do you think? As long as it's just as friends! Damn! Just outright rejecting, holy shit. That's a what? I mean, oof. I'm gonna just say, please come visit. I should. I would love to see you. Part of me doing sounds choking for something siring. It's so stuffed. Rip. Thanks, man. I'm really excited. Oh, what about your plans with Emma? I'm gonna say I'll talk to her about it. Because we don't want to be mean to Emma just for, like, no reason. Seems rude. Okay, I just don't want to mess things up. What do you want to do this weekend? This is some straight people bullshit being like, I think that every person who you hang out with is also a girl, that you are into her, that's the only reason why you would hang out. So, I'm like, Jesus Christ. Do some stuff about campus. Whatever around campus. That misogynistic SMHing, yeah. Sounds good to me. Should I bring my alcohol? SMH girls can't have guy friends. Yeah, I always thought I was super stupid. And it's one of my biggest pet peeves that I have with... especially books. Whenever there was any plot where for like no reason people would have random beef. Because like in children's books it's all that like girls versus boys. And I was like, why? There's like no reason. I mean, I say that as a guy who's had primarily female friends as a child. But like, you know, that's just misogyny. You should have that as a pet peeve. Yeah. I don't know. It's just upsetting. Because like a lot of people don't really like... think about it through a misogynistic lens, but it is. It's just straight up misogyny. Should I bring my alcohol? I'm gonna say I have some. Yeah. Okay, I'm so excited for finally come and visit. Oh shit, I actually have to run. But I'll see you this weekend, okay? Of course. Yay! We're doing our best. Bye. Emily is away. In a way. Alright. Yeah, 2004. Did people just say the phrase vent? Like, to vent to someone? Sausage. I saw someone touching something about that with a jazz riff. And that's what you call misogyny. That's my interpretation of what I think it sounds like. Sparkles. That is so true. Junior year of college. Alright. Bleh. Silly. Out of these ones, I'm gonna go for the low-key... this looks like the straight pride flag and the gay pride flag are like fragmented. So I'm getting that one going. This looks like loss. It probably is loss. Or it's like... I don't know what it's referencing specifically. Hey! Period. I'm gonna say... hey, exclamation mark, because I'm excited. I'm always excited. I know it's been a while since we last talked. I'm gonna say, no worries, which is something I really frequently say. Like, I say no worries so many times. It's actually stupid. I've just been going through a lot lately. What's been up? Why are you always trauma dumping on me, though? Can we just talk about it? Like, I mean, it's fine, but also, just the stuff I had to deal with. So I was hoping we could talk about things. You say, of course. What's up? Why the fuck do I have my OO song by Slime Sickle, my timeline, Simon? I feel like things are kind of weird between us. Have you felt like that? Say, I don't think so. Be neutral. I think it's because of last year. Aware. Yeah, well, you were all like, why did you kiss me? And I was like, I don't know, man. I came to visit, you know, please be honest with me. Did you plan that we would hook up? Ain't no way. We hooked up, holy shit, sex was had. Also, what do you mean, did you plan? Like, why does she think I do everything intentional? I didn't do shit, man. Sometimes this shit just happens. What do you want from me? I'm gonna say... of course not. Heterosexual intercourse. Of course I didn't plan that. Yeah, because it sounds like a little manipulative if you were like, inviting you over when you're vulnerable. Just in retrospect, it all seems so planned out. How? Literally, you were like, hey, I want to visit. Is it okay? What do you mean? And we hung out with your friends around campus, and then we go back to your dorm to drink. Did you want us to get really drunk? No tip on tip action. Nah, Jesus Christ. I mean, you could put different tips together. I'm just going to say it. sorry. I regret everything. Do you want us to get really drunk? I just wanted to have fun. Actually, never mind. You wanted to hurt. Yeah, trans people. They do be real. No way. Can't believe it. I just wanted to have fun. I don't know. And also, me erasing, you wanted to hook up. This is what I'm saying. Like, why is Emily manipulating this shit? Like, just be for real. Like, I'm getting some sus vibes from Emily. Like, I know, me too, I mean, I get regretting maybe hooking up with someone, but like, don't put this on me. I'm gonna say, did you not want to hook up? Emily, I'm in the manipulation station, ragey. No, at least I thought I did. Just a lot happened really quickly. Yeah, this made me feel differently. I'm gonna say in a bad way. Different in a bad way. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It seems difficult. No, not bad, just different, I don't know. Will we ever be the same? No. I'm gonna say, are we still friends? Yeah, at least I think so. That's good. I'm sorry, things are really weird for me right now. But thank you for talking to me about it at all. Can talk anytime. So how's school going and everything? I'm gonna say it's alright. It's alright, just same old, same old. So how's your friend Mike? He's not really my friend, he's been a tool lately. We're gonna say he's not really my friend anymore. Because I want the drama, guys. I want the drama. Yeah, it sucks when people change. Damn, Emily. What about your other friend, Emma? I'm gonna say we hang out sometimes. Just to hang out sometimes. Is she just a friend or... Emily! People can't be friends with people they could be in relationships with. I'm just so frustrated. Like, oh my god. I get it's 2005. And that was like... You know, people were a little bit less... We just talked about it, SMHing. I know, but... I'd like more maybe. I'm gonna say, she's just a friend. I don't really care about Emma. I'll be so for real. Oh, okay. I'm sorry, I don't think I can do this right now. By that logic, you could be dating all your friends. I mean, you have more than one hand. I'm sorry, but... I just really think it's stupid when people assume that if you're friends with someone that is of a gender that you're attracted to, that you automatically have to be attracted to that person. Stupid. And also, blah, silly. Sorry, I don't think I can do this right now. I'm gonna say something wrong. Bien, bi people can't have friends then. By that logic, Tabian. Yeah. No, talking's just kind of hard. I got to go soon anyways. I will talk again later. I'm gonna say of course, because I'm a good friend. Yeah, yeah, like yes, I definitely choose my friends based on how much I want to fuck them. Yeah, you just do like an analysis when you become friends with them. And then you're like, you know, I mean... fucking village. I mean, in my case, most of my friends are people that I'm not attracted to. Like, just on the basis of they are not the correct gender. Giggle, yeah. I have quite a lot of femme-presenting friends. Snick. This is 17 again. Oh my god, this looks like FNAF. I know it's FNAF. No idea what this is. For a sec, I thought you were gonna say that. I go, no, my friends are all cute. Ha ha ha, Freddy plus. I'm gonna take the whale. Howdy, I'm gonna go howdy again just for the lols. How are you? It's hard to argue when you won't stop making sense, but my tongue still misbehaves and keeps digging my own grave. I walk from this dark room for the last time. The past is just that. Damn, you're deep. Howdy. Hey, hello. I'm gonna say, how are you? I'm good. This is some stale texting. How are you? I'm gonna say, I'm alright. How did she get your real name? Ah! That's what I'm thinking. I mean, she knows me in real life, to be fair. I mean, I hope she knows my real name if we've hooked up. Alright, oh good. I'm gonna say, have you been? Well, yeah, but your real name in real life, PPOS? True. I definitely am just called Yellow in real life. It happens. Do you have any plan? Everything's been really good. What's new in your life? Nice name, though. Does she have a new boyfriend? Not a whole lot. Recently, just finishing up college. Oh, I don't know about if you knew me and Brad got back together. I was about to say, like, girl. Also, girl. There are more choices. I'm gonna say, that's great. Because we're polite. I can privately think it's dumb, but... I'll be nice. Thanks, how's your friend Emma doing? I'm gonna say not great, I guess. She started dating Mike, so now I barely see her. I'm sorry. I'm gonna say I have other friends. It's okay, I have other friends. Do I though? What are their names? Well, college is almost over anyways. Will you miss it? Give me names, Megalol. Yeah, I guess so, but I'm excited to be done too. I'm gonna say we had some good times in college. Yeah, kind of. Message. I'd rather not think about the past, though. I'm gonna say, oh sure. Sounds like you're definitely feeling great. I'm just tired of reliving memories. All set for graduation. The voices, the memories, yeah. I think so, I still have to order my gown and stuff. What are you doing this summer? Why do we care about Brad? We don't care. We give literally one singular shit about Brad, and that's being silly. Just hang out with here with Brad and try to find a job. How's your week been going? Been alright, pretty busy. What did you do today? This is some one-sided conversation. I don't think we should push to see each other, just go to homework. Why are you asking about school again? I'm just gonna say goodbye. Yeah, I went too far. Okay, I think I'm going to go. Goodbye. Yeah, because all of that, like, do you miss things? Like, she just said she doesn't want to think about the past. Yellow is away. Shock. Drama. We did it. I accidentally generated a rap battle between Yellow and Jimmy Buffett. Oh my god. Oh, I mean, this game I think has a really cool aesthetic. And I like the concept of setting it in this time period of Instant Messenger. But Emily is just a really, like, uninteresting character to me. Because she's just a very stereotypical character, like someone who isn't particularly socially aware of the time. Emily just kind of uses us constantly to dump about shitty things going on in her life, and then whenever, like, her life's good, she just abandons us. So I don't think this is a healthy relationship, which is why I was like, I'm gonna draw myself away at the end. And she gets back together with her shitty boyfriend, and, like, she basically blamed us for hooking up with her, even though literally she was the one who had the idea of visiting us in the first place. Like, what the fuck was going on there? So I don't know, I feel like this is a 4 for me. Because I think the execution of the idea is very good, but I didn't love going along with the plot. And I mean, I would probably play like the future games if I had the chance, but I think this is one of those cases where I'm more in love with the aesthetics and the UI design and everything rather than the story. Yeah, I think the future games are better, not as. Still, like, had a good time, like, finally playing this game because I've been seeing it around, I've seen some people play it. So, I found it, like, a nice experience to just try it out and see where it's going. So many endings and achievements that are about just using a specific type of icon. Alright, are you ready for the first surprise game, chatters? Pause, champ. Pause. We are playing a silly game. Next game, hi P. Called Cooked with Love. Which this is a dating game, but it's also about food. Hopefully this will pop up. Pause, will it run? There we go. See if it has its own soundtrack. I have no— oh my god, it has a very loud soundtrack. Sorry, chat. Oh, Jesus Christ. Show. We'll do dyslexic font. Security chat. Of course. I need to first set it up so I can show the chat. Hopefully it'll do. Nope. I found itch.io games really hate being done with itch.io games really hate being shared through screen, game capture, sorry.
I agree with your stance.
Hello. Tabien. Right, I'm trying to fix the— I hope you don't mind, it's like a little weird cropped. I'm trying. Bro's trying. New soundboard sound just dropped. Real. There you go, you're actually getting the nicer screen share because it's— I could do it as full screen. But then I can't see chat! The pain! Well, catch up, ooh. Alright, let me read you the little description for this. Cook with Love is a short comedy slash romance visual novel with crafting elements. Nudge, use your phone. I can. Alright. And I thought that sounded really cool. It is a free game. I'll get the link up in the chat really quickly. There's absolutely wonderful, complex, beautiful looking visual novels for free on itch.io. So if you're someone who enjoys visual novels, have a little gander. Can you see well, chatters? I would recommend— oh, I cannot see my mouse cursor. That is horrendous, but okay. We'll try our best. Uppercut spin. Alright. Let's get in. What a beautiful morning. You wake up right as your alarm sounds, full of energy, with enough time to get ready for class. That is so real. I said you wake up! You're going to be late, aren't you? Wake up! Shit! You stumble out of bed, stubbing your toe as you scramble for your phone. Nice one. You quickly dismiss the 3 alarms you've managed to sleep through. We can only see the options now! Can you? For me it's showing it. Can you not see that, chat? Now it shows it. Oh, maybe it just didn't refresh. Sorry. Apologies. Better get ready fast. Yo! Okay, we gotta get into this. It's very difficult to see where I'm selecting stuff. Can I not change my name? Ah, there we go. Yellium is back in the house. There we go. We'll have short hair with trousers and... Oh my god. Truly everything you need to be a crypt into the world. Do you wear shirts, skirts or trousers? Is your hair long or short? And what pronouns do you have? It me. This does not look like me, but okay. The voice is pronouns. The pronouns are here. Well, this is as good as it's gonna get. Cool, bro. Ugh, can't believe I'm going to be late for the first lecture of the semester. Peeper comfy. Peeper comfy indeed. But after that New Year's resolution I made. Well. First lecture of the spring semester goes smoothly. You manage to duck into the hall without anyone noticing. Jackpot. However, it's what, or rather who, awaits you at the bus stop that has your palms all sweaty. Is staying on the older part again? No! Maybe it's because it isn't in full screen. Maybe I can fix it somehow. Maybe it'll allow to be... I can't tell if it'll capture it. That way it probably won't. Ugh. Alright, I think I have to do it as a... Because I also can't see my mouse cursor very well, which is kind of orcs. It's like just not anywhere. There we go. I just need the settings! Bro! Can I... It's so hard to navigate without being able to see your mouse cursor options. Alright, I'll go back to windowed. I'm so EP. Wah! Wah, EP. Alright, I'm trying my best. Can you see the options now? And is it like... Okay, I'm gonna... Go here and load this. Yellium lost precious little life. Yes. Gross, is that a medical condition? Wait. I go one back. Oh, gross, is that a medical condition about our sweaty palms? Do you see this? About us being sweaty. No, not the person. I was about to say. Yes, this is... Am I just being incredibly rude? About this random stranger? Alright. Now it works? Okay, I guess we just have to have like that slightly... awkward bit of cropping around the edges, soz, fellas. But these are like really little indie games, so absolutely do not worry. Oh, I don't know why I said do not worry to you guys, but it's just it comes with the trade. You get a free game, so. Can't expect it to be the best, like, adjusted to every single cross-compatibility. You wipe your palms on your trousers, you take a hesitant step forward. Gay panic. Come on already, you spent all night psyching yourself up for this. Hey, your voice comes out in a whisper, you cough and try again. Hey, Lily. Oh, I made us straight again. No! Despair. It's gay if you play as a girl. Oh, hey, Yellium, right? Yeah. She remembers my name. That's a good sign, right? Right? Sure, buddy. What's up? You're so excited about her knowing your name, you forget... Completely forget everything you rehearsed in your head last night. Nice going. Got a moment to talk about the environment. Cry and throw up. I'm tempted by cry and throw up. I'm so free. The gay panic was too strong. Well, in this case, it's straight panic. Because I made our protagonist a boy. Terrible. Can't believe we're spreading the straight agenda. I'm gonna say it. Nothing much, you. Just waiting for the bus. Oh yeah, me too. Girl, this is a sham. I'm sorry, I didn't know the love interest was femme presenting. I mean, they could be not. a girl. They could be non-binary, you never know. They could be a boy. You know, let's not assume, but... Look at that jawline. That is a strong jawline. We have the same face. Lily just has eyeliner. Girl's been mewing. I love how I'm just silently standing. Come on, man. That bus is going to arrive any minute. You promise yourself you'd suck it up and just ask out, freaking ask out. Just do it. Don't let your dreams be dreams. Monkey King, we have an emote for mewing. Yes, because I think this cat's hilarious. I'm going to say ask out. Here goes. So, Lily, I was wondering. Yes? In the distance, you see the M79. Lily's bus. Not that you're, like, a stalker or anything approaching. Thankfully, it has stopped for a red light. But, you know, you should probably speed this up a little. I was wondering if you'd like to go out with me? Hang on, don't speed it up that much! You cough. I was wondering if you'd like to go out sometime. Not sometime. Friday night, 7? Yelling, my boy! Why are you literally the most awkward person ever? I mean, I get it, but also... Get a grip! Oh. I'd like that. Yes! Let's go! Really? I'm just gonna save again. Really? Sure, did you have anything in mind? Oh gosh, it's a surprise! Alright then, I look forward to it. I'll meet you at your house, text me the address. Text you? You still have my number from that group project before, right? Oh right, got it. Great, well this is my bus, so I'll see you Friday night. I can't believe that worked, man! Imagine if we had picked cry and throw up at the start. I doubt that would have worked then. Great, awesome, see you, have a good bus ride. You watch as her bus peels away. Have a good bus ride? And then I told her to have a good bus ride because it's the only thing I could think of. Brooks. Why is Brooks here? Can we date Brooks instead? Like, what is this half lumberjack, half like thirst trap bro outfit? Also, this art style, is it just me? Does it kind of remind me of, what's that show that's set on an island? That's like a reality TV show. Anyone know what I'm on about? Total Drama Island? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking of. Like, this guy looks straight up like he could be in the show. Lore, way to go! I still can't believe it. That's such a weird thing to say, right? Do you reckon she thinks I'm weird now? Who cares? What matters is, you finally did it! Isn't he in the show, Siring? I've no idea. Siring, he looks like a guy in there. Well, maybe he is, I have no idea. I guess so. Proud of you, bro. Thanks. Decide where you're going to take her yet? Not yet. I guess I got a lot to do before Friday. Can't believe it's already Friday! Oh my god, we're skipping ahead. That's right, it's tonight. You all set for your big date? Hell yeah, you bet I am. I got us a reservation at the Savory. The Savory? That's the nicest restaurant in time. Where'd you get in town? Where'd you get that kind of money? Giga chat. Grandma is really funding our dating life right now. Nice. Grandma Law coming in clutch with the big bucks. Yeah. She was so happy to hear that I was, and I quote, finally going on a date with a nice girl for once. Instead of hooking up with some guy at a foam party? Wait! Bisexual Yelium is real? No waying. Also, that's such a grandma thing to be like. I'm glad you're going with a girl instead of, you know, being a fuckboy. Happy enough to find us this whole date. Sweet. But dude, it still weirds the hell out that you tell your grandma everything. I might need to leave. Oopsie. No worries, King. It's been lovely to have you. Why, we just have a really good relationship. It's perfectly normal.
I agree with you.
Oopsie, I'll leave you with a sad bot spam. Cat jam, soundboard. Take care now. It was lovely to have you, King. We'll do this then. Boop. Hate to break it to you, bro, it's really not. Whatever, man, I don't need to hear this kind of talk about my grandma. The bus is here. Your bro Brooks is kind of right. There are some things you really don't need to tell your grandma about. But anyway, the bus is here and you reach in your wallet, your pocket for your wallet. My wallet! Yes, your wallet. You keep your bus pass in it. It's gone! Well, things have taken a terrible turn. I've only got enough for my own bus fare, too. This sucks. Home's not that far. We'll walk back together. It's good exercise anyway. It's not that. What about my date tonight? Probably just left it at home. Come on. Come on, we'll run back and find it, and you'll be on your date before you know it. I really hope you're right. You're wrong! It's not here, of course. Maybe just didn't look. No, I know it's not here. I bought that pack of gum earlier, so I definitely left the house with it. Oh man, Grandma Gum's gonna be so disappointed. Come on, it's not so bad. I'm sure you'll think of something. Hey, you're right. Brooks, buddy, bestie, bro, Seth, you're definitely gay as hell. You're rich, benevolent, kind, generous, freaking amazing parents sent you any more money lately. yeah? Well, come on, do a bro solid. Not that I don't want to, but I'll pay you back this time, I swear. At least as much as I totally believe that it's well. Look, I spent it all on new clothes for Maple already. What? Are you kidding me? Yeah, I got him a whole new set of clothes for the new year. And that used up your entire monthly allowance? Freaking doll clothes for your teddy bear? Oh, bros really need to build a bear, I guess. Hey, the craftsmanship on those tiny sweaters is worth every little bit I paid. And more. You're ridiculous. You throw yourself onto your bed. I give up. I'll just cancel the date. I'd have probably made a total ass myself if I've gone on the date anyway. Oh, come on. Don't give up so easily. What other option is there? I don't know. How about you, cook her dinner? That's always a romantic move, isn't it? This is, I think, the, well, crafting element of the game. Me cook? You cook? You're right. He is. I am. Yeah, I mean, how hard can it be, right? Famous last words. Sure. Oh dear. You mean, this is all we have to cook with in the whole house? To be fair, we have been living off takeaway for the pasta, always. Well, I guess I better get started. Need any help? No offense, bro, but I've seen you strain pasta by dumping it all in the sink and picking back up each piece of tortellini by hand? Dead. Hey, you still ate it? That's somehow worse. Anyway, shoo, I have work to do. Fine, I'll leave you to it. Once Brooke leaves the room, you survey the ingredients in front of you with an appraising eye. Appraising an eye as someone whose entire culinary experience is 1.5 episodes of MasterChef can possibly have, anyway. So, I've got to make 3 courses, right? That's what they do at fancy restaurants. I guess I could start by grabbing something or another and pouring some seasoning on top. Starters are usually simple anyway. Alright, we've got ramen. Bag of chips. Muffin. A granola bar. String cheese. Fish fingers. Banana. And egg salad. No. What are sauce options? Seasoning. We've got some balsamic vinegar. Maple syrup. Soup mix. Cream of celery only, and protein powder. I'm thinking, what about banana and maple syrup? Hope for the best. Mysterious starter, no! It's soft, crunchy, hard, undercooked, and burnt all at the same time. How did you make this with a banana and maple syrup? My brother in Christ. Bon apple tea. Well, that's one course done. This is turning out easier than I thought. Who knew? Maybe I'm a natural chef and didn't even know it. You are not. You are not. Next up, main course. Probably wants to have something starchy and add whatever on the side, add some seasoning. Okay, well, out of these, ramen, fish fingers, and no, not balsamic vinegar, the soup. Yes! I'm a genius! Fish katsu ramen, fusion ramen, innovative cream of celery broth topped with breaded cod or something. At least the main's good. Tomato, right? Nice. How there's this only dessert left. Plants are with the remaining ingredients. Oh man, what else can I work with here? Whatever. Let's just cobble together two things and see what I get. Oh, that's awful. Why is this is awful? Chips and cheese string. Oh, ooh. Okay, that's all three courses. You take a step back and admire your handiwork. Mysterious starter to start. Fish katsu ramen as the main. And finally, mysterious dessert for dessert. Oh, I'm sorry, Lily. I can't serve this. Try again. It's basically inedible. What's going on? Brooke casts a casual sweeping glance over the dishes you prepared. Looks fine to me. Please, take it for what it is. It's terrible. Nah, it's not that bad. Would I ever lie to you? I'm gonna cancel the date. You start typing out a message on your phone. Dear Lily. Hey, don't do that. You continue to type, but faster. Just take a sec to breathe. It'll be fine. It's just not my day. You're looking forward to this day so much. Don't throw your chance away over something small. I'll never be able to live it down if she comes over. You know what? I'll reschedule for another time. Or lifetime. Or never, maybe. Alright, you've already made up your mind. So I would suggest you don't throw everything out. Why? No one should be subjected to eat this. It'd practically be torture. Won't be that bad. We've eaten weirder things. I don't want to do this to you. Well, there's also our only food left for the rest of the week. Oh shit, you're right. Unless you think we could get away with stealing Nicole's packed lunches for a week. Ah, she's so stingy, she once asked me to Venmo her for using toilet paper she bought. How could she have even known? Has she been measuring the rolls with a ruler? Then I'll go set the table, you bring out the stuff. Just think of it as a nice meal between friends, how about that? Alright. Starter. Bring out two plates of mysterious starter placed on the table. Are you sure this won't give us diarrhea or something? Only one way to find out! With a deep sigh, you take a seat at the dining table. Even the fact that it's been cleaned for the first time since you moved in doesn't cheer you up. Unsurprisingly, since you know you bombed your chances with a girl you've been hiding over for ages. Hey, it's not the end of the world. I mean, it sucks, but at least you didn't, kill a man or something. I know. Sure calls for a drink or something. Yeah, let's do it. Celebratory drink for this dinner. Alright. Let's take a shot! Glass of wine, maybe. Well, so fancy. Don't expect too much as $5, Chuck. And I'm pretty sure it's the course. For one, for sure, she's the only person living in this house willing to spend that much on wine? Brooke, my boy. $5 for wine is not expensive. Even a glass bottle instead of a box. It's going to be a date, so I had to step it up a little. Even if it means Nicole's going to kill me. I appreciate you taking the risk of seriously pissing her off for me. Pour out what you hope is an appropriate amount into two clean plastic cups. Two of you attempt to clink your wine glasses together. I say attempt because they're plastic. Well then, let's eat. This is rather interesting. Eats a small spoonful. Yep. Oops, that doesn't look good. Hope we don't get sick. You'll try this before you serve it. Nope, there's already so little. Fair enough, I guess we shouldn't waste food. You could use eating, taking very small spoonfuls. Dude, I'm gonna be alone forever. Hey, one mistake isn't going to define your entire love life. You say you were going to reschedule. You could say that. But I'm going to take this as a sign of where this relationship is headed towards. So maybe I should just not contact her ever again. Ah, you gotta start somewhere. You'll never know unless you try. Maybe you'll be good at this whole dating thing. That's wishful thinking. I'm going to suck forever since I can't even get a first date right. Aw, don't be so hard on yourself. You need more practice in the dating scene. You'll get it next time. You sound like a self-help book right now. That's what I'm here for, to bestow inspirational quotes upon you. But I mean, is finding someone really that important? Just add another thing on your plate. Sick of hooking up with randos. Damn, Yulium. I should settle down. I feel like a loser being single. Why doesn't anyone love me? Out of these... I guess it might be nice to settle down. With someone I like who likes me. I see. But you know, it's not like someone will fall out of the sky like in the movies. What movie is that? Clearly he doesn't mean literally. I'm not really looking for a whirlwind romance or anything. It's like something chill. What's that gonna look like? Wait, can we date Brooks instead? My ideal situation would just be spending my time with him after class, maybe going to the cinema or cooking dinner together. Well, maybe they'll cook and I'll wash the dishes or something. So I'm essentially looking for something like this? Pause champ. Can we make it gay? K Can we make it gay? The dinner you're having with me right now? Guys. Yeah, but maybe not with me as the chef. That does sound pretty nice. I mean, you could do that with people you meet for the first time. That's pretty much what first dates are. Yeah, but I was thinking more of a relationship where we really get each other. Like, it's not awkward, and it's not just at night or drunk. Just like you and I, you know? I'm just gonna be for real, man. There's a hot man right in front of you, Yelium. Like, you don't need to even leave your house to... Too bad I'm a dude. Did you not hear? Well, maybe Brooks doesn't know. Sausage. I don't think it really matters. But yeah. I love- Brooks just does not know about us hooking up with guys at foam parties. Oh. I see. What do you mean, I see? How do you do it though, since you're single? Don't you feel like you're missing out? Me? Not really. I mean, I've been on dates before, but I haven't really had a serious relationship yet. I thought you did. Ah, come on. You would have known all about it. Come to think of it, we never really talk about our pre-uni relationships much. What's your experience like? Nothing unlike you, what you've seen. Nothing serious ever. I can't remember. I'm going to say nothing serious ever. Non-existent. I've liked people, but that's all that's ever happened. A lot of pining from afar. That's not creepy at all. It isn't. But okay. Uni made me a whole different beast, though. Ah, the power of alcohol? Yep. What a curse. Think of it as a rite of passage. Most students go through it. It makes us stronger people in the end. I guess it helps me talk to people without reservations. Trust me, we'll look back on these days when we're middle-aged and laugh about it. Really hope so. It'll be these stories you tell your future partner and baby, Yelliums. Thanks, Brooks. I don't know if hookup stories are something I want to tell my future partner or kids. I mean, if you're a cool person, it'll be funny, yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Or me, at least. Why don't you take the last bite of your mysterious starter? Well, might as well bring out the main course. I'm kind of excited. Don't get your hopes up too much. I still want to know if we can hook up with Brooks instead. Soon enough, you turn with the kitchen with two plates of fish katsu ramen. How about another drink before we get started on the main course? Of course. We should have... Dusty Alco Pops? No. Tequila! Okay, fair enough. Where's the lemon salt? Since when do we ever have lime at home? Good point. Sloppily pour a shot's worth into two cups and hand one to Brooks. Here goes nothing. Alright, now that we have our drinks, let's see the dish. Feast your eyes on one good dish. Okay then, that's it. That's all you have to say? It looks like food. Eh, was that so hard? Anyway, are you feeling better about canceling the date? Only because of you. Yes. Come on, we can so make this. We can so turn him gay. Yeah, only because of you. I love you, man. That man is doing all the lifting. are you drunk, bro? I mean, I'm glad you're here with me, instead of me being all alone. It's chill. Come on, we can make him gay! Come on! This is my quest now for this game. I don't even care about Lily. Love you too. He holds his fist up. You put your hand on top of it. Yelium, my man. I know you're too gay to function, but... Be for fucking real. Nah. I was aiming for a fist bump, but that works too. Nice going. You give him a half-hearted fist bump in return. Awkward. Ugh. Oof, it's getting awkward. Let's dig in. Oh, sweet, it's ramen. With fish fingers? Interesting. Tentatively tries a fork full of noodle and fish. It's pretty intense flavor-wise. Should you have given the food a taste before serving it? Defend your stylistic choices. Yeah, I wanted to go for a flavor bomb. Really bedazzle those taste buds. Taste buds are definitely overpowered, but I'm not sure about the dazzle. It just needs some time for the old razzle-dazzle to settle in. Yeah, bro, I'm just not feeling the old razzle-dazzle. Well, there goes your cooking career. But seriously, two students spending Friday night at home, and it's not even close to finals week yet. Are we becoming grandparents? Shows what you know, grand-grab usually hits up Friday, bingo Friday nights. But I don't think I'd be in the mood to go out right now. Yeah, you did have your date scheduled for tonight, I guess. So I'm spending quality time with my bro. We were both broke, so going out is going to get us nowhere. Right. How about we discuss your game plan? What do you mean? What could you do to put yourself out there, score yourself, and maybe me some dates? Just go out with me, Brooks. Just be cutting out the middleman. I'm sure you've got something in mind. Learn how to cook, hit the clubs as usual, practice being on a date, get a job, drink more. This one is some sass vibes. Like, this is some clever fucking finagling. I could practice being on a date. What? Why? For fun. I need help. I'll be honest, it's because I need help. Like, sure, I managed to get Lily to agree to hang out with me today, but like, what would I do after that? It's hard to plan these things. Usually I'd go with the flow. It goes awkward otherwise. I mean, obviously you don't want to say anything that'll offend the other party. You're a good person, so anyone would have a great time with you. You can just be a little bit disoriented sometimes. Oh, thanks, but disoriented. Losing your wallet? Fair. Even if we did find ways to make me more dateable, I don't know if I have it in me to ask Lily out again. Probably thinks I was just playing her for a fool. I mean, I don't know her, but I'm sure she's nicer than that. There's always other fish in the sea. What about that dude from the foam party? You seem pretty into him. What? And so you know about it, but why were you, like, confused about me dating guy? Like, what? Huh? I thought he just didn't know. That's why he's, like, confused about why I'd say, like, I love you to him. But, like, if you know I'm queer, like, wouldn't you have a bit more vibes? Like, I'm confused. Huge mistake, bad time of my life, I need another drink. Another drink. I'm going to need another drink before I give my answer. Pour two more shots of tequila. Sure about this, bro? Shots. Many times shots. Everybody! Of course. Alright, since you're so excited about it. Woo! Oh god, we should probably take a break after this one. Okay. We don't need to get absolutely hammered. The yes or no on foam party guy. Probably not. I think anything would ever happen there. I mean, it was just a hookup, and I don't even have his number or anything. Nothing's gonna come out of that. Ha, that's what she said. Do people still use that joke? No, they don't, Brooks. They really don't. I've no idea. Anyway, are we done? Yeah. Stacks the utensils on the plate. Okay, let me get the next dish. There's dessert too? I thought you were kidding. Of course there's dessert. This is a 3-course meal after all. Wow, going all out for a special someone? You didn't have to. Gonna show him the best. That's some flirty undertones. Return from the dish kitchen with your last dish. Sweet, I'm so excited, you really shouldn't be. He eagerly checks out your dessert. Ah, this again? No, it's its own unique dish. You say so, I don't think my stomach can handle this. You're imagining it, just breathe in that aroma, it's delicious. Look a little green to me. No, I'm totally fine. One more drink to finish off this night. Honestly, bro, you should probably drink water. Nah, I'm fine, no worries. Let's see. We're definitely going more tequila. Might as well go out all out tonight. Yeah. Bartender, shots, please. All right. Pulls out 2 shots. A toast to bros. And down goes the tequila. Anyway, let's take a look at what you've made. Honestly, I can't taste the difference between this dish and the one earlier. Really? You don't think this one's softer in texture? Soft texture? I just bit into something crunchy. What? No way. The two of you continue taking little spoonfuls to find out the correct texture of this dish. Because that's obviously the smart thing to do in this situation. Put your spoons down, having cleared up the plate. I know we're broke and have no food, but I don't think I'll do something like this ever again. What do you mean? Eating your food, that is. Come on, it's not that bad. I feel like there's a stone in my stomach right now. You notice your stomach feeling a little heavy right now. It might even be gurgling. Yup, something's very wrong. Don't we have some Tim's somewhere, or Tom's? Right, I remember seeing a bottle. You look through the cabinets, knocking things to the ground before you find a dusty bottle stashed away on one of the top shelves. Brooks, I found it! Yelling upset to your stomach a little more, and a dull pain spreads quickly in your abdomen. You struggle to pry the bottle open, revealing one measly tablet at the bottom. Well, he's nowhere to be seen, so... Hear the bathroom door slam shut upstairs. And this is all mine! Before you can get the tablet out the bottle, you feel your stomach become a geisha. Food shoots up through your throat, out your mouth, and you spray a dark, chunky mixture all over the counters. Ooh, jeez, what a mess. Oh god. Good thing no one was here to witness this. From above, you can hear Brooks in the bathroom hurling his guts out. At least from the sound of it, he's managed to get in the toilet. RIP. Probably best to start writing your apology letter and clean the mess in front of you before the smell gets any worse. That would be a pain to clean up, yeah. We did get love, guys. We just had an awkward conversation with our bro. Love the Kevin McLeod music. This was fun, though. A bit clunky with, like, capturing it. Wow, that could have gone better. Luckily, now that you've completed one playthrough of the game, you've unlocked something to help you out. Once you start a new game, you'll be able to see hints in orange text when you hover over ingredients in the crafting screen. Try not to poison anyone next time. That's hype! I didn't even know that it had a system where if you play it more than once, it has extra stuff. Extras. Kevin McLeod, done it. Made with Renpy. I've seen that one. This was pretty fun, I'd say. 4.5. I really like the aesthetics, the music's good, the story was fun, interesting. And I do like that you get more in question mark by making different foods and having more playthroughs. Well, yeah, do check it out, Kings. It is for free. We might do another run of it another time. No, wait, we should. Oh, we didn't save very often. That's a pain. Well, that was pretty cool. I like that. That was a vibe. Alright, are you ready for the next one? Chatters are mine. Boop boop. Then, also, how did you like this one? Because this one was the first of the mystery games. I thought this was really cute. I liked the crafting element as well. And I do want to know, like, if it is possible to date Brooks. If we do everything right. Or, like, at least hook up. That would be fun. It does say two pursuable characters, so I have a strong feeling maybe. It says there's 11 endings, which is pretty cool, and each of the playthroughs is like 50 to 20 minutes, so that's pretty cool, I guess. I would definitely play this one on stream again as well, like, I'll put it to the games we've started. Because I want to try if we can get, eventually try again for the Brooks ending. Alright, the next one. Is another cooking, not cooking, another date preparation themed one called Heart on Your Sleeve. Which is a feel-good visual novel about how self-image can affect interactions with others. Offers a number of choices for a split round experience, each revealing something more about the relationship between the protagonist and Taylor, as well as exploring concerns about comfort, appearance, and insecurities that accompany them. Which I thought sounded so interesting, and the art style looks super cute. Just all the good vibes. There we go. Do-do-do. There's some voice volume, nice. Alright. Start. My name is Yaliam. There's an itch under my skin that I can't scratch. Persistent, pointed, and pernicious. Like a bug bite, the more I pay attention to it, the worse it gets. Beams of sunlight strike my face through the blinds, signaling the start of sunset. All at once, I'm made awfully aware that the passage of time has no patience for my cold feet. Instead of granting me with a sense of urgency that could spur me into action, however, the awareness only fills me with more dread. Paralyzed, I can only squint and urge on the rays to leave me alone. Tonight won't go well, I know it. I'll make a fool of myself, or they'll finally realize they could do so much better than me, or... Abruptly, I noticed the hand I threw over my eyes, trembling ever so slightly. After another second, I also realized how shallow my breaths have been due to the tight knot in my chest. And that's when I forced myself to breathe. I've actually played this really cute. Yo! JKS. I clenched my hands into fists, take some deep breaths. In, out. It smells like summer. Head out. The air's unusually humid. It might rain soon. Probably a good idea to grab an umbrella before leaving later. Wow, I'm glad I at least took notice of that. It takes being drenched in rainwater off my long list of concerns for this looming date. It'll be fine, it always is. Okay, that's a lie, it isn't. But one way or another, things will work out. That's what they told me, at least. Sometimes when you're ridden with too many worries for one person to handle, you just have to stop caring and let fate take the wheel. I clench my fists slowly, imagining their fingers spreading across my palm as their hand slips into mine. Aww. Kind of cheesy, admittedly, but it's nice enough of a thought to make me feel less like I'm suffocating. For now, that's all that matters. Yeah, it'll be okay, I think. As I begin to gather back my senses, I realize that there's, in fact, still plenty of time until I'm supposed to meet with them. I almost wish that this weren't the case. Since I managed to calm down, I would have preferred to push through all the way with my current state of mind instead of leaving enough time to get lost in my thoughts again. Continuing the thrilling activity of staring at the ceiling would only accelerate the inevitable, though. I should tidy up my room! My room isn't that messy, but I can always use some work, really. I lift roll myself out of bed, and after reveling in the tragedy of the separation for another few seconds, I scour around my room for something that could provide me with a menial task. Eventually, my eyes settle on a particularly cluttered corner, deeming it to have enough potential to provide me with a suitable amount of distraction. I kneel down to it and set about sorting through the mess. A pair of jeans should have gone into the laundry yesterday. This pair of jeans. And I was wondering where those coupons had disappeared to. They've expired just a few days ago, damn it. It goes on until I'm eventually left with an overflowing trash can and a pile of things to put back in their places. That pile can be dealt with later. For now, I'm just zoned out, satisfied by the progress made. I'm snapped out of my stupor from a pitter-patter on my window. I look out to see raindrops dripping against the glass. Right, an umbrella. I'll need that. It takes a bit of searching before I find it, since it wasn't where I last put it. Yo, I've actually found it between the crack between my desk and the wall. When was it? Was the last time I used this? Probably on our first date, actually. Aw. It'd been raining then, almost a torrential downpour, but they still wanted to meet up. There's no way I could call it off when they said they were too excited to let some bad weather stop us from spending time together. Aw. Held the umbrella the entire time and walked me back to my apartment, even though my place is way away from theirs. That's so cute! It was special. I felt treasured almost in a way I rarely do. When we said our goodbyes, I could see how soaked their shoulder was. I immediately felt a surge of shame for having it let go unnoticed for this long. Their grin made it evident that they couldn't care less, though, so I decided to stay quiet about it, pushing down the apology that was at the tip of my tongue. If I fretted, they'd prioritize reassuring me, and that was the last thing I wanted. I wanted them to just enjoy their good mood without me throwing a wet blanket over it for the sake of my own conscience. I looked down at the umbrella in my hands and grip on its handle. Would they offer to hold it for the both of us again today? If they do, am I supposed to accept or say that it's my turn to return the favor? What would make them happier? Does any of this even matter as much to them as it does to me? That's so real, though. Real as fuck, these inner thoughts. The clock in the corner of my eyes catches my attention as its hands shift to the next hour. Most of the sunlight is gone too. I've got to start getting ready soon. With a sigh, I leave the umbrella to rest near the front door and head over to the closet. Here it is, the next obstacle I've been putting off for as long as possible. Wardrobe time. I've got quite a lot to choose from here, thanks to my roommate lending me their clothes, which means some of the stuff here is outside my comfort zone. But well, nothing wrong with the new experiences if it comes to that. I also can't try every single one of these since I only have so much time. The game, thank you, James. Not to mention that the amount of combinations possible with all these items is bound to be ridiculously large. After browsing through my options, I decide to arrange together some outfits and choose from those. Show me the options! Indeed. Cardigan, tank top, wide leg pants, and flats. Blazer, that's fancy as fuck. Blazer, turtleneck, slacks, and dress shoes. Leather jacket, grey jeans, and buckle boots. That's cute. Open jacket, tube top, slit skirt, thigh high socks. Hoodie, t-shirt, leggings, and sneakers. I'd wear this. Out of these, this one. This is like fancy but not too fancy. It's a little bit bold, it's a little bit cute. The perfect one. Ah yes, the leather jacket, an icon of badassery. That as well. I've seen people who wear it like a uniform every day and all the time. It kind of becomes a part of them for as long as that phase lasts, which can range from days to decades. More frequently though, people buy it thinking, who doesn't like a leather jacket, and reserve it for their I want to feel cool days. In other words, it is a universally accepted cool look one way or another, but well, I just really don't like the way clothes fit me. The synthetic leather squeaks as I pull my arms from the sleeves. I grimace. Based on the smell of chemicals that strike my nose as soon as the jacket's on me, it's pretty clear that it hasn't left the closet often. Looking at myself in the mirror, I see why. The jacket and I, we're not a good match. It looked like I'm trying so hard to look tough, but failing laughably at it. The sleeves tether looking short enough to be silly, and my awkward posture's a dead giveaway that I'm not used to wearing something like this. I at least try to get as comfortable as I can in it, which isn't much. The jacket itself is a tight fit, and since it's barely been worn, the leather's still stiff. Putting on the boots was an entire chore of its own, too. I didn't get to celebrate for long once I figured out the buckles, since now I could physically feel how heavy they are. I really wouldn't try to walk for too long with these on. Some sacrifices I expected for the sake of fashion, I suppose. But are the sacrifices worth it, considering how miserably I'm failing at the fashion part of it? Is this outfit? No. And this... You just seem... uncomfortable. Like, this is crazy, though. Like... We'll go cozy. I mean, this is not a first date, this is like a continued date. Didn't really put much thought into this one, admittedly. Featuring one of my best friends, my favorite hoodie. If there's any piece of clothing that's stuck around with me through thick and thin, it's this one. The outfit isn't all that fitting for a date, but it makes up for it by being extremely comfortable. Now that I'm actually considering the outfit as a legitimate choice, I just really don't like... maybe the outfit itself. I glance at myself in the mirror, then pick off a few lint balls of one sleeve and frown. Easy to point out the spots in which the material is worn thin and faded from all the washes it's been through. I might as well be going out on an errand or hanging out with a friend. It's certainly not the look of someone who's about to go on a dinner date, at least. Oh, it's a dinner date? I didn't know that. My imagination brings me a few hours into the future. Under the awning awaits Taylor, dressed to impress. Leaning against the restaurant walls as they swipe through their phone. Their face is illuminated only by their screen until they notice me, which is when they step closer to greet me under the streetlight. Their eyes briefly light up when we make eye contact, only to fade in disappointment as they take in what I'm wearing, girl! Your anxiety is not going well, King. I'll be suffering. I expect to hear them saying, look what the cat dragged in an attempt to liven up the situation. My cheeks burn with shame anyway, and that's just from imagining it. Even the softest hoodie ever made wouldn't be soothing enough to make up for that scold. The clothes I picked out specifically to feel comfortable in are stressing me out this much, huh? There's enough irony in that fact to make me scoff. Choose this outfit? No. If it's a dinner day, like, maybe we should go super fancy. They say it's better to overdress than underdress, but isn't this just way too much? This wasn't supposed to be a formal outing from the get-go, and I knew that. You just said restaurant! I got these dry cleaned and ironed just in case anyway, so they are available. I just really don't like the way clothes fit me. I stand in front of the mirror, shifting around in an attempt to get the blazer to wrap around my form more shapely, like it's supposed to. This looks good on them, though. I try straightening my posture more, tightening the cuffs around my wrist, and pulling the pants closer to my waist. Yeah, dinner date, not fancy dinner date at all. Well, it depends what kind of dinner. I just think restaurant is so vague. It could be any kind of restaurant. But I say that as a guy who likes to dress fancy, so I don't really care if it's too fancy for the occasion, because I get excited. Like, sometimes I stress out if it's, like, appropriate dress for the situation. But a little fancy, like, this person, like, they're wearing a turtleneck, which is less fancy than a shirt would be. There's no ties, no cufflinks, it's a blazer. I mean, the bottom bit is kind of eh. Clothes don't look right on me. It's not different from how I looked during senior pictures where I sat there and smiled awkwardly at the camera in formal wear that fit me like clothing borrowed from an elderly family member. I'd winced at the flash, then winced at the picture when I saw it in the yearbook, and now I find myself wincing again facing my reflection. There really isn't much to say about this except that I look silly. At least it doesn't look like I care. It doesn't look like I don't care, I guess. Regardless of the way I look at it, the suit that makes it clear that it isn't made for just any occasion. Anytime it's brought out to be worn, it's done so with intent. Even if it doesn't look flattering on me, that much can be conveyed with the choice of outfit alone. No. If it's like just a casual... Like, I don't, just really don't want to dress super femme. But that's just a personal preference, because I'm playing this if this is me. And like, I would not wear a skirt. I would wear shorts with like thigh-high socks, because I think that's fun. But also wouldn't wear anything that shows my stomach. Like any sort of cropped look. I think I could live with this, even though I wouldn't wear flats. The cardigan is my roommate's idea. It's not like I don't trust their judgement, we're put pretty good terms, but our senses of style are, well, different. Not a loose fabric, but it's manageable. It's more of a question of whether or not it's worth putting up with, in addition to making sure this date goes well. Which I really don't like. My clothes fit me. As I turn around examining myself, the cardigan slowly slides down my shoulders, forcing me to draw them back up. That's gonna be inconvenient in the long run, isn't it? I raise my hand to see how the bracelets fit on my wrist, and the cardigan falls off again. Scratching up my nose, I pull back over my shoulder, only for the other side to drape down this time. Yeah, no, this is going to be inconvenient in the long run, it already is. Can't you replace this cardigan with someone else, but the drapery look that I'm going for would be incomplete without it. We use safety pins to keep it attached to the tank top. No, but what if I need to take it off? It'd be so awkward to pull out pins from my shirt in the middle of the day. Or worse, I could forget about the pin altogether and tug the cardigan too hard. I'm wondering why it's not coming off and rip the fabric. Yeah, so no safety pins either. Yeah, this person has some serious anxiety. I cocoon myself in the loose fabric and scowl at the mirror. If I wear this, probably fiddling with it all night. I really do enjoy the look of the outfit though. The decision is going to be a matter of how nice I want to be to my future self. I'm gonna pick this outfit. Because you can always just take the cardigan off. And I would like something to fiddle with, to be fair. I like fidgeting with, like, fabrics. I can't say that I'm entirely satisfied, but well, I'd be here all day if I tried to be. So once I decide I'm ready enough, I put on my shoes and head out. The drizzle from earlier stopped for now, and there's still a trickle of sunlight spread across the horizon, casting a hazy glow on the streets as I walk. Air is tight around my skin, even as the light breeze picks up. Prickling here, pulling there, tugging this way and that, like an itch I can't scratch. The wind is tugging around my clothes too. They flap and flutter even in a breeze as gentle as this one. I gather the two halves of the cardigan in one hand to hold them together as I walk. I clench my jaw for a moment before taking a few deep breaths. The air is humid, hot, and almost hard to swallow. It clings to my throat, cloying and strangely comforting it all at once. Yeah, I'm glad I brought that umbrella with me, because it's gonna rain again later for sure. Wait, would a belt have helped? There's no point in thinking about it now. I'll just take the cardigan off once I'm there. Hopefully it's not too cold indoors. It'll be fine. It'll be okay. I repeat that mantra under my breath a few times, quiet enough to be unaudible to anyone else, and continue making my way to the restaurant. I should lose my pace, especially since I'm already running late as is. So I approach the restaurant and notice Taylor leaning against the wall just outside its door. Aww, they look cute. Hard to miss since they insist wearing that fur-lined jacket and scarf regardless of the weather. I can't help but wonder if they're really fine under all that cloth and this humidity. They look up in response to the sound of my footsteps and their whole face brightens as they realize it's me, waving enthusiastically as I get closer. It's impossible not to smile back to a welcome like that. Before I can even think of apologizing for being late, they say, "Are you a sunflower because... achoo! Bless you!" Taylor laughs, holding up a finger. I couldn't have timed that better if I tried. What I meant to say is, "Are you a sunflower because you brighten up my day?" Aww! That's cute. I raise a brow to their joke, to which they raise theirs back expectantly. Corner of my mouth creeps upward until I give it a grin widely. Unbelievable, you didn't even try with that one, did you? Whatever could you mean? Do you know how floppy sunflowers can get when it's rainy? Don't tell me it's gonna rain today. Can't be sure, but it did rain earlier. Enough for your sunflower over here to get all droopy. And so we continue on the exchange, heading in no particular direction. Unlike our aimless back and forth, though, my mind is still set on a specific concern. I cross my arms to try and keep the cardigan together, pulling some slipped fabric back onto my shoulder. They don't seem to notice the first time it happens. On the second time, they only throw a quick glance, and otherwise leave the conversation uninterrupted. So on the third slip, they stutter mid-sentence and keep their gaze on my shoulder for more than a few seconds. Ah! I'm just saying, it was definitely intentional. This was all planned out by me. I knew that this would be a banger flirting technique. I got that one. Definitely on purpose. Aw, this is very sweet though. You're having some trouble there, aren't you? Let me try something. Confused, I lean over when they gesture for me to move closer. When I do, they carefully ease the fabric off one shoulder and then the other. Then they step back for a moment and nod. Yeah, I can't keep falling off if it's already off, right? I adjust my posture to look down at myself and the sleeves slip down over my wrists. Well, an attempt was made at last. At least, with an indignant huff, I pick up at the cardigan. I'd better be looking nice enough to make up for how much of a nuisance this thing already is. I can confirm that you look very nice. I'm not the one wearing it, though, so I can't say if it makes it worth the trouble or not. At their genuine compliment, I clear my throat in embarrassment. Well, I guess it is now. Thank you, you're looking good, too. Barely a compliment, but their smile shifts into something more shy. They clear their throat and tuck their hair behind their ear. Aww. You're not just saying that as a diversion, are you? Of course not. I mean what I said as much as you did. An undeniable satisfaction of having the tables turned against them this time, and with so few words too. They really are clumsy at being on the receiving end. Content, I watch the mumble of thanks before grabbing my hand and leading me to the restaurant. Come on, let's head inside. My hand is warm in mine and sends a little thrill up my spine. Aww, this is so cute! Soon enough, the hostess seated us. At first, as we settled in the booth across from each other, I was too preoccupied. The lump of nerves lodged in my throat to pay much attention to anything else. My eyes bored through the menu to make sure that I'd have my order decided before the waitress came around our table. Only after completing the nerve-wracking ordeal of reciting my order, I was free from my tunnel vision. And now, with my elbows on the table and chin resting on my folded hands, I have the leisure to notice how they're fidgeting ever so subtly. When I hear the stumble in their words during their order, the slight strain in their laugh, when I see them glance back and forth and push their hair back again, I have a moment of realization. They're just as nervous as I am, aren't they? Aww, this is so cute! I had an inkling that this was the case ever since they reacted so bashfully to my compliment, but for what? However the rest of the night goes, I'd be happy to just have spent time with them. Oh, the answer's been staring straight at me right from the start, hasn't it? I picture them pacing about their closet, digging through the racks and shelves to put together a suitable outfit for the night. During our last date, they told me a story. They told me how at one point they once impulse bought a nice shirt that they knew they were never going to wear, swore they'll wear it for a special occasion, then proceeded to never let it see the light of day. They said that they meant to wear it for our first date, but by the time they found the poor thing shoved into a corner of their drawer, there wasn't enough time to smooth out its wrinkles. Suddenly, I can't resist my curiosity. Hey, your shirt! As if caught off guard, they drop the straw into the lemonade too abruptly, and the ice almost clinks over the edge of the overfilled glass. Yeah, did I already spill something on it? No, but is that the one you said you meant to wear last time? Oh yeah, it is. I didn't think you'd remember that. Oh my god, this is so cute. I'm gonna cry. Ugh. You went out of your way to tell a whole story about it. I don't see why I wouldn't. Yeah, but I also tell a lot of stories. Some of them are more memorable than others, like the ones focused on you. I haven't heard you tell a lot of those. Huh, really? I guess I just have an easier time remembering things about others. What? Then do you mainly talk about me when you tell stories about our dates? Putting it like that is embarrassing. I laugh about how they turn to frantically inhale lemonade. Their pouty glance gradually turns into something more softer, their straw resting at the corner of their lopsided smile growing on their lips. Once my laughter subsides, I give them back the best smile I can. The rest of the meal goes on like that, with more stories exchanged and another memory made. A memory that would become a story of its own later on. Aww, this is so cute! Thanks for tonight. As we walk out of the restaurant, they nudge me with their shoulder. Had a really good time. There's a little wave in their words. Since I first noticed it, it's only become more and more evident. What can I do to help? What can I say? Me too. They look away for long enough for me to trance their gaze, wondering what's taking a hold of their attention for so long. I find myself staring at a lamppost out of all things, counting the raindrops that fall under its light like shooting stars, until they finally interrupt the silence. Do you mind me walking you home? It's late and all, so... Yeah, of course, I mean, no, I wouldn't mind. I internally grimace at my stammering, but getting that permission seems to settle some of their nerves somehow, and well... That's at least one mission accomplished, albeit not with ideal performance points. When I finally meet my gaze again, I feel like I need to say something more, something clear and in my own words. And you know, if I don't keep talking, I'll lose the momentum. I really do mean it. Tonight was great, and I always enjoy your company, so you don't have to be so nervous. I mean, there's nothing to get right or wrong in all of this. Besides, like, basic decency. You know what I mean. A smile breaks in their face, followed by a chuckle. A little hypocritical, don't you think? That's so true. That's so true. Before I can reply, they speak again, softer this time. But I get it. It's hard, and it means a lot to me that you'd say that. But while we simply stand there to bask in the moment, I find myself staring at them just for the sake of it. Alas, yet again, I lack the wisdom to check the forecast before heading out today. With a dramatic hand on their heart, they tilt their head, and my other hand that's holding the umbrella. Aren't you so very glad that at least one of us decided to? I stare down at the umbrella, then glance back at them, obviously waiting for me to hand them the umbrella. It'd become our routine for each rainy day. After contemplating, I give them the umbrella. When I reach out and hand the umbrella to them, their face immediately brightens. We did this last time too, didn't we? And well, you looked happy back then. I was, and I'm more than glad to do it again. As if to prove their point, they hum as they let go of my hand to open up the umbrella. They stand to face me and I find myself smiling back at their eagerness. Just, don't get water all over your shoulder this time, okay? Will do, not to worry. Their response feels a touch too flippant for me to even feel reassured by it. So, as they raise the umbrella over us, I wrap my arm around their waist and hold them flush against me. Yes! Story Yellium, pulling out the Riz. This is so cute as well. I'm actually like... Oh my god. I mean it. If you can feel any drops fall on you, get close like this, got it? Yeah, got it. Crystal clear. We made our way back leisurely, as if we had all the time in this world. Even though the nighttime streets were still teeming with people, the walk felt just as intimate as if we as it would if we were alone. Just the two of us! I felt as if I could say just about anything under this umbrella. As if I could trust in the rain's pattering to drown out any secret shared between us. None of the words we exchanged had much substance though, nor were they meant to have any. I couldn't say with confidence if I'd be able to preserve this vibrant memory over the years. What mattered to me was that tonight happened at all, and I had this experience. There was someone beside me that I wanted to share more of these moments with. That was special, no doubt, but what made it so was that I didn't want it to be special. I wanted the sense of warmth to be a norm, for both myself and for them. So when we inevitably had to part ways, I had a special farewell in mind. See you soon, and that prospect of a next time, which they confirmed with their response, more than made up for the disappointment of today being over. We'll see you! Aww, this was so cute! Oh my god, I actually was like about to cry because this was so sweet. Aww. I really like this. Sorry, it's so sweet. It's so cute and I really like how they had that moment of realization that the person they went out with was feeling just as nervous. Man, this is a 5 on 5. I would say not someone who gravitates like crazily often to visual novels. Because I'm like, I could just have to like put a lot of effort into reading out all of the dialogue and everything when I'm playing for stream especially, but this one was so sweet. The art style, the sound design, the main message. Check it out, it's for free. It's wonderful. It's very like, it's just very sweet and wholesome, but also with a nice message as well about trying to not be super hard on yourself and that other people in your life might also be really anxious about something, but can be worth pushing through that anxiety. Very sweet. We'll see. I will try the final game as well, but I don't know if we're going to continue, like, finish the entire thing. I don't 100% remember how long it is, and my voice is dying a bit from doing all of that reading. So I'm just going to guesstimate my best. To avoid obviously fucking up my voice entirely, but we'll start it, and if it's too long, for today. We'll finish it next dating game stream. I've been really loving these visual novels, but they do take Jesus, as you can hear, they do take more energy because I have to read out all of the dialogue and there's a lot of text. So we are gonna have our final game today, which is a letter-based game called Hoping This Finds You Well. This just gave every vibe ever. So this is an experiment in letter writing meant to evoke the distinctly sweet homoeroticism of Victorian and Edwardian literature. Follow the correspondence of two professors in the months before one of them makes a decision he'll never be able to take back. This just gave big gay energy and I was like, yes! What was the name? Hoping This Finds You Well. It looks like this. I was like, yo! Thank you, James. Do you know this one, James? Oh no. Oh, it has accessibility options. Actually, don't. I'll use Open Dyslexic in case anyone's dyslexic here, but make the text a bit bigger. Oh my god, it can self voice!
Fun, self voicing volume. Font override. Text size scaling. Line space. Cell. Font override. Font override. Font override. Text size scaling. Line spacing scaling. High contrast text. SELF voicing. SELF voicing volume drop. The options on this menu are intended to improve.
That is annoying. Well,
SELF never mind. Voicing disable LED.
I was like, oh my gosh, it has TTS, but this voice is very difficult to listen to, in my personal opinion. Very... Yeah, I've seen it too scared. It will be sad to play it. Alright, we'll see if it's really sad. Hopefully not. I love the art style as well. The 5th of Anti-Spring 1904. To Dr. Hawley Faraday, my most earnest and warm-hearted congratulations on the doctorate. Your anxieties were utterly uncalled for, my friend, and your medical degree was an inevitability. I realize that in the face of that which we most desire, it can seem the height of folly to assume. But the acceptance of your thesis was not luck, but written stone. It is merely the logical progression of your efforts and unsurpassed cleverness. What a bold thing you've done, submitting that early draft of your thesis to me, out of the blue, with what I cannot characterize other than to call it a demand. Make it a bit quieter. There you go. Before that day, I had not heard of the name Faraday, and it is with the same strange sense of fate that I assume I shall not be forgetting it anytime soon. I fear that my previous paragraph might come across as something of a complaint, some sort of backhanded bit of unpleasant peasantry. 1,000 apologies. It is hard to comment on a temperament that breaks with social norms without sarcasm seeming to enter the mix. But your correspondence is frank, insistent, and always amusing. What seemed a novel turn of arrogance was proved to be a warranted self-confidence as soon as I read your writing. This is all to say that I regard you with the highest esteem, and want to assure you that the name of Faraday rising in the academic world is a singular turn of good fortune for the academic establishment at large. Thank you, James. And to that end, I write to inform you that I have submitted that most esteemed of names to my superiors. Between my students and my own external research, I require rather a lot of assistance, and have requested that the office indulge me with an assistant professor. You will no doubt be getting offer after offer for employment, but it is my sincerest hope that you might consider coming to work in my department of the University of Anatich. Its reputation is no doubt known to you, even if the department is not to your liking, after some 3 or 4 years here. According to the page, the game is around an hour long. Yeah, it said like 30 minutes to an hour, I think, so we might do like half of this today, just because, like, even if, like, if this was any game where I wouldn't have to do as much reading, we'd do like everything, but since this is the third game where every game required me to read out loads and loads of dialogue, I'm like, my voice cannot do that. I'm a bit out of practice, I have to say, to do like long streams where I talk like constantly, so we'll do like about half, I hope. Its reputation is no doubt known to you, and even if the department is not to your liking, after some 3 or 4 years here, you'd be able to take your pick of recommendations as you continued in your career. Write to me when you can, and if the idea of joining is abhorrent, I shall wipe the idea from my mind and never mention it again. But if it is pleasing to you, then I shall update you on the progress and assist you in beginning your application. I remain, as always, very truly yours, Harold Ludichel? MD. DCL. LLD. HRF. Professor of Supernal Biology. Jesus Christ, bro. Long brag. While reading, you can click on the stamps to drag letters left and right. This will allow you to experience two different times. The letter as it's being written, and the letter as it's being read. Oh my gosh. Pinky Raiders. So thank you for the follow, Shadow. Welcome in, Kings. We're just starting a new game, so you're perfectly in time. We're playing some dating games today, and we've started with a game called Hoping This Finds You Well. It's about two professors and their homoerotic letters. So I hope you're excited, and I hope Pinky's stream was wonderful. Settle in, get all cozied up, make sure to get hydrated, and just all in your mind. We might not finish the entire game today, since it's about 30 minutes to an hour long, and this is the fourth game with a lot of reading out loud of dialogue for me, so we'll try our best, guys. Mouth reveal, alright. Epic. Yeah, so this is Hoping This Finds You Well, which I just think looked super cute. So we can have both these perspectives. The 9th of Anti-Spring, 1904. My dear Professor Ludichel, I've only just received your letter. I'm responding as rapidly as I can possibly, as I possibly can. We're only making port for as long as it takes to resupply. You speak of fortune, but I commend my own sense in opening your letter as soon as it was handed to me. And now I hope that my haste will not render my entire response illegible. Yes, yes, 100 times is not enough, but you understand me. You speak very humbly about the University of Anatich, where there is not an academic who does not dream of entering the establishment. I could not hope to afford to attend, and at times it feels as though all eyes have willfully passed me over. But you see fit to have me there, working alongside giants all the same. To see. Look! You can see them, like, what the other person reading the... They're like, that's so cool. Take that unceasing enthusiasm you have for my work and use it to impress upon your superiors that I will have that job. I will absolutely not be foiled in my desire for it. It was a kindness of you to assist me with my thesis, and I will demand that kindness once more. This will need to be brief. The captain is calling. All hands to return. Join the lark. Expect a longer letter to follow. I will write one on the ship. Know that I consider you to be, and hope that you see in turn as, your friend, Holly Faraday, MD. Dramatic. It is now the 16th of Anti-Spring. Write your form. My dear Dr. Faraday. He's looking serious. I have received only one letter in this past week, but as I have news, could not wait a moment longer to share it with you. The head office has conferred and trimmed my list of candidates for assistant professor. They had the most proficient sense not to strike your name, as it remained when the list was returned to me. I was given the final selection and refused any time with which to deliberate. You may now choose at your leisure whether you wish to respond to the title of doctor or assistant professor. The term starts at the 2nd of Anti-Autumn, and I would be most pleased to welcome you some 2 or 3 weeks early, so that you might settle in and come to know the basics of educating university students. He's like, yes, let's go. The matter is settled, and I await your questions, and in time, your arrival. Regarding a different matter, I do hope that you are safe. I don't mean to hover over you like some worrying hen, but yet mentioned that you are at sea currently, sailing beyond the eastern coast and the canal. There are most dreadful reports of piracy along those shores. I find myself revisiting my childhood eagerness for tales of seafaring adventures. Shame burning my face to think how carelessly I enjoyed to hear tales of storms and bloodshed. Never once had I stopped to think how grisly they might be for those unfortunates who found themselves in the midst of such events. Pisces. Bro just disappeared, it's just a line of glass. Oh my god, I'm losing it. I will be thinking of you and praying to one of our local gods for your safe return. He's still gone. I do hope I will vex you not too much. I will vex you too much, and admit that it is likely more for my peace of mind than it is out of genuine superstition that it might rescue from the grip of ruffians. Forgive an aging man his little rituals, and trust that I do remain your friend, Dr. Harold Ludichel. Drama. I'm hoping this continues to stay fun and sweet, but you never know. 20th of Anti-Spring, 1904. My dear Professor Ludichel, what excellent news, even better than that which I inform you now. While I cannot claim to have been untroubled by pirates, I will state that I am sound and as safe as one can be at sea. I remain largely below deck, though it does please me to emerge at night. The farther one sails from the coastline, the less light pollution there is. Once again, the grand expanse of the constellations emerge, and all is peace. I prefer the nighttime. Is he also gone? Oh, crap. I need to remember to pull it up here. Sorry, I didn't see one of the sections. I also cannot stand to hear you calling yourself aging. You may be my superior in academia, but I have done my diligence. Your age is scarcely 7 years my senior. What is it that compels men in their 30s to call themselves old? I cannot understand. I suppose all ages that are not youth or freshly marriageable are considered dead in the water, eh? Damn. Well, barring any additional seafaring catastrophes, I should not hope to reach that age myself in a year, and I assure you, I am not yet prepared to be bagged and splashed overboard. Perhaps, as the bell chimes midnight in a year's time, it will all become... Lol, I agree with Blondie. True. Perhaps as the bell chimes midnight in a year's time, it will all become clear to me. Barring that, I will ask you very firmly to wait until your hair is graying before affecting my dear friend with such libel. So I'm gonna assume he's, what, 29? And the other guy's 36? I've seen your photograph attached to one of your monographs. And when I pick- for gay ass. And when I picked you, it is the rosy- I do love how the- spelling is like slightly cut off. The rosy hue of a mature, vigorous state. You can be. Regardless, the prayers for my safety, do as you wish. The sailors make offerings, wear charms, and sing their prayers into the night. And for their efforts, we are granted smooth waters and a strong wind. The sea and the winds are not without hearts of their own. If your local god will put in a good word with them, I see no reason to do anything but accept it. On the subject of that, your thesis was on the similarities between shrines, churches, and locales where demons and other such creatures make their habitats. The presupposition that demons and gods belong in a similar class of creatures, not a new one, I was impressed by the rigorousness of your data collection. I mean, he wants to have him collect his data, if you know what I mean. Especially the section which demasated local what decimated. Oh my god, this is so difficult to read. Yeah, I don't even know this word. Demasated locals where cataclysms or unsavory acts had occurred. You did not draw the conclusion yourself, but I cannot imagine that it had been at least noteworthy to you. One might expect a church register highly on your list. It was instead the prisons, poorhouses, asylums, and battlefields, which were of note. I've read from some of your detractors, who have read between the lines, calling your results blasphemous. They are filled with studies that attempt to explain away your results, but they do little more than affirm your findings in my eyes. To that end, I've been taking my own readings as I've traveled, plan to begin the fruits of my labor along with me. I realize that your own thesis may be an interest which has passed you by, but if there is a chance that it may assist in your current undertakings, I should be happy to put it to use. If not, then I will be happy to publish privately, and your work will have one more cross-entry of support. Fret not if there is a gap between my letters. It is the ocean which deprives me of opportunity, and not a disinterest on my part, who remains to be your good friend, Holly Faraday. Jesus Christ. The drama. First of mid-spring, 1904. My dear Professor Holly Faraday, you flatter me immensely, believing that I had not already begun to gray in my mid-twenties. It is a common affliction of the high-stress lifestyle of academia, but one easily rendered moot with the regular application of dye. Understand what it's like to not measure up to an expected image of a man, and frequently when a man is condensed down to words, the mind's eye of another is much kinder to him. Your flattering image of me is, I believe, one such kindness. My own visage has a long way to go before it appears either rosy or vigorously manly. Had we met on the street, I would like to think that I would still been taken aback by your brilliant mind. But, being the fallible humans we are, it is very likely that some bias would have prevented the growth of our blossoming friendship or our joint studies. And to that end, I would welcome any readings you might bring with you. You have seized upon the foundation of my latest work, and though I dare not write about it in these early stages, my current results appear most promising indeed. While you have been taking these notes and measuring chemical levels, have you run into any supernatural creatures? Are I a betting man? I would wager good odds that your results show that supernatural levels rise around reports of demonic activity, that those reports also tend to come from seedier or more wretched locales. In Alienage, we are naturally aware of their existence, but they are, as a rule, covered up or destroyed as promptly as possible. Wherever gods may exist, have the good sense to keep themselves hidden. Or if their visages are half as gruesome as those of the demons we could find, I assume that all worship would promptly cease. Of course, these little thoughts of mine are more of the same blasphemies with which the churches have taken such deep issue. I ask that you keep these bits of conjecture between the two of us. I'm operating under the assumption that the difference between demon and god is not one of kindness, worthiness, or love towards humanity as a whole, but instead one, merely one of size. I'm certain that several worshippers of polytheistic religions across the globe would be in agreement with me, and it's an acceptable theory to teach here at the university. But outside institutional walls, the Church of Eunominance followers disagree so vehemently that to utter the truth to their ears is to begin a raging argument. Thus, there persists a delicate balance of teaching my own findings and not raising the hackles of some of the school's more affluent and pious donors. So already my research does not come without certain outrage from some corners. What comes next is what I truly must request you to keep quiet about. For if we are to follow this line of scientific inquiry, where next shall we take it? I suppose we shall make a game of it. Assistant Professor Faraday, what is to be done next, keeping in mind what our research has told us? It is with the uttermost eagerness that I await your next letter, and I trust that I remain as ever your good friend, Harold Lutachow. Jesus Christ. I'll save. Cause oof, my voice is dying, chat. Oh my god. We didn't dive too deep into this one. But, ugh, Cat Kiss, yeah. Four games where all of them are visual novels or games with lots of dialogue that doesn't get read out by the game itself. That gets on the ye old pipes. But we do continue this in a future dating game stream. I thought this is a very interesting game, a unique concept, and hoping it doesn't turn sad. So far, it's quite sweet. But yeah, I hope you liked the games today. I felt like they were a good mixture. Emily is Away wasn't as good, like as compelling to me personally as I had hoped. But the second game, Heart on Your Sleeve, was my favorite. I thought that one was just chef's kiss. Cooked with Love was really nice, like interesting, kind of funny. But and I do like that it has multiple endings, replay value. And this one here, I'm intrigued, but we of course haven't seen all of it, so I'm refusing to hold a judgment. And if you don't know, we do more of these dating game streams relatively regularly. We've been doing one a week, approximately. So we will continue this one and also start new other games. I found so many cool ones on itch.io. All of these that we've been playing today are free games, so check them out. There's lots to be enjoyed about these, even if there's like little things that are a bit unpolished. I always kind of take it with the context of it being games that are given to us for free by these developers. So I'm not critiquing these like as deeply as I would a game that I've paid money for. Speaking of games that I've paid money for, I actually did get two games to play on stream really soon. During the spring sale, I got A Little to the Left, finally. This was a sub goal from the last subathon, so we will be playing A Little to the Left on the channel relatively soon. And also, next week on Tuesday, so mark your calendars, we are playing the new Moomin's game, Snufkin Melody of Moomin Valley. I'm very hyped for it. It looks super cute. I've been excited for this game to come out for a long time. So excited, in fact, that I bought it full price without it being on sale. So hopefully you'll enjoy it as much as I hope to enjoy it as well. It's a very cute little musical game centered in the Moomin universe, which, if you don't know it, it's cute little creatures, a cute little cartoon franchise. So hopefully we'll have a good time and that executed as a video game as well. So that, and then next week we also have demo day, of course, on Wednesday. We have some NSMP modded Minecraft on Thursday, and Tiny Life and Death and Taxes on Sunday. So a nice schedule with a good mix. We've got Minecraft, we've got indie games, we've got some new stuff, we've got some old stuff. So very excited for all of that, and I will see where I can send you over, chatters. Thank you so much again to Pinky for the raid. I really appreciate it. If you're new here, do follow. We do indie games, Minecraft, other stuff. So always a good time. I don't know where I want to send you. I might send you to Akko, who's doing a 12-hour stream, and currently doing what is Akko doing at the moment? Playing Supermarket Simulator. I've seen this one around. I'll follow with the raid as well, because I want to find out if that game's cool. So join it over, lads, and I will see you on Tuesday. Sorry for taking a few days off, but I have some appointments on Monday, so I don't really have the energy or time to stream on that day. And Sunday, more chores to be done, so I will see you on Tuesday for the Moomin's game. Hope to